10 seconds remaining. Dire team ban. Radiant team ban. Remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Dire team ban. Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Hello, hello, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the Genting Southeast Asia Qualifiers. My name is Hades, and I'll be your caster for the best of three series for the day. And our first best of three, starting out with a pretty interesting matchup, we have Team EVOS versus Entity. Alright, so Team EVOS, I know these guys because they took out a Singaporean team full of pup stars, and I gotta say, I was quite impressed playing a Necrophos mid. There was some stuff, and I think you're gonna hand it to Francois. He's a pretty player, and these guys, from what I understand, they are the former Zero Latitude. So, my bad, a bit early. We're a Myanmar team. Yeah, these guys are from Indonesia. Alright, so Entity Esports. So, I think you guys may know players from the team Beyond Infinity, and can't really recall who exactly was on the team, but I do know Blizzard, I know No Chance, Swifty, guys, I think a bit of a glimpse of at them at the ASIC ROG Masters in Kuala Lumpur, where I did attend spectator. It was pretty interesting. They have quite a good, quite a nice looking uniform as well. Mention. Well, I'll tell you guys the story later on, but otherwise, we have ourselves a draft, and EVOS on the dire side will open Shadow Demon and Luna. Very hard to go wrong with that combo. Entity Esports immediately replying with Ogre Magi, Timbersaw. Of course, with that versatility to be able to go into the offlane or the mid. Ogre Magi is just one of Enki supports who can just stand in the front, and Bloodlust is an amazing as well. Not to mention, of course, a bit of RNG. You have multi-cast, and of course, you say no to Ignite. You just get an orb of Venom, you throw out that Ignite, run someone down because you're just that tanky and annoying. Of course, Ogre Magi, you think, you're probably thinking to yourself, okay, maybe he's ganking potential by himself. Not exactly that good, but this doesn't deceive you. This guy can really get, really, really annoy you. Get under your skin and everything. Alright, but Entity Esports taking Ladder, Tanking, and Evoker. Take a look at the EVOS like drafting history. These guys really favor Disruptor and Warlock. They might even set it up with a Shadow Demon and a Warlock, purely because Fatal Bonds is a spell. Great team offering. They might still pick it up. Well, Entity at the same time is one of those teams from here. And guys, gotta say, they're quite talented, still uprising team. Nice upcoming team. And good ban. I guess Entity are one of the few teams to consistently run it. But anyways, Team EVO actually ban out the Warlock for themselves. Okay. or something else, you could also run into the Shadow Demon or Soul Catcher, and of course provides you pretty much an amplification damage output regarding the nuke. Luna,
10 seconds remaining.
Soul Catcher, woo-wee, a lot of damage.
5 seconds remaining.
Alright, so EVOS, yeah, they are pretty known for their invoker bit as well. And these guys, do you know how to impress now and then?
Dire team pick.
So how are you guys doing all the way in Twitch chat? Hope you guys have a good day. I'm pretty excited for this game. You guys doing all right?
Seconds remaining.
Tide Hunter.
All right, so a Tide.
Radiant team pick.
A stable pick. It's still okay. Entity have a pretty good chance of actually taking this game, but currently I would feel that EVOS do have the upper hand because these guys, I would say, a bit more experienced. Just. You're comparing like some of the players beyond Infinity, Latitude. Guys, they go back quite a way. I think a while back, it's like a year and a half ago. Maybe even longer than that, 2 years. Like, I recall some of these players when I first started out as an amateur cast. So anyways, coming out, my physical damage output could actually just shred apart that huge... I love that red meat. Alright, so Axe will be the band.
10 seconds remaining.
So Team EVOS, you might want to have some extra setup. Remaining. Just a bit more disabled. Tide, of course, with that bit of AoE, so some total great team Reserve fight, time. Not to mention Farm of Ancient as well. Care of that. Timbersaw. It's one of those annoying heroes which can actually still tear through the Luna very, very easily. And Warcry, I would say, great because early on that help as a counter defensive mechanism against the Luna's physical damage, where she doesn't really scale that. The proper term is she doesn't really build up that quickly for damage output. Like, you really wanted to farm up the glaives, get some extra farm, maybe win a couple here and there with that nuke damage which she has been provided with. In a way, to a certain extent, she's almost like a glass cannon. Alright, so Team EVOS, we're cutting to more of the bonus time. Of course, these guys, I understand the latitude, they got picked up at EVOS Esports. Of course, thanks to the guy who did ban me, who did tag me on Facebook, telling me to tag them, their official page. I didn't know, because apparently on the joint Dota page, I see the EVOS logo? Alright. Anyways, right, we're starting out with a 4th pick. Team EVOS, what extra support you would want to go with the Shadow Demon? Go back for the Elder Titan. So, good, pretty good. Natural Order is going to, of course, take care of that base armor. I'm going to be relying severely on that Warcry. Luna, I don't have a much easier time. At least you can land a Stomp. Bind that with the Earth Splitter and the Ravage. The Wombo combo up, it's really, really good. So far, Entity Esports, however, do run on shorter cooldowns, with the exception of God Strength. So maybe you want to take one more support. They still could go back for Oracle. Promise, always a useful spell. They might even just go back for Keeper of the Light. Blinding Light could be an amazing thing. You just want to make sure that you can cut off the fight. It's a bit split up Team EVOS, you don't really want to fight them eagerly. They will go back for the Disruptor, so that's, you know, of course, potential Static Storm and Kinetic Field. We all know those very annoying spells. The only Kinetic Field could actually win you that fight. The Static Storm, of course, trapped the Luna, forcing her to go into a BKB. Might even use it into silence the Tidehunter, making sure he doesn't get off the Ravage.
5 seconds remaining.
Both teams having their fair share of crowd control. Of course, both their carries are able to flash on very quickly into the Battle Fury and Sven. Glaives from Luna. Camps are never gonna be... Think about it this way, both teams are actually able to steal ancient stacks very easily as well. So I wouldn't be surprised if you see, you know, the Battle of the Ancient Stacks. both heroes who could potentially use Helm to dominate this stack multi-taps. For now, I'm still really not too sure whether Entity Esports are looking to put Tempest on mid. Could. Team EVOS still hasn't picked up a lane and probably could be looking to see here is for Entity.
10 seconds remaining.
Behold the Horn of Magnus.
Dire team pick.
Anyways, hope you guys are doing all good in Twitch. A good day, Dota TV as well. Thank you all for watching. And yes, alright, so Magnus will be the final pick for Esports. This is really tricky. It is. So for now, I wouldn't say that the Magnus or Timbersaw have set lanes yet. They want to look at they want to look basically at who the final pick for E. And they could still go back to something like maybe a DP if they want to go for a bit of a push. That's where you can really synergize your Wombo combo. Just win one the Ravage, Earth Splitter, and blah 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 for a push with the. They will go back for the DK. Well, yeah, okay, he's okay. He's really, really tanky. In this case, I wouldn't say no. Timbersaw mid, Magnus into the offlane. Well, if you look at it this way, we have been seeing a bit of a change in how you would want to lane. Especially as Magnus, like we don't usually what we used to see was maybe a 4-2-2 kind of thing, where like after you get through, you just go straight up more points to the empower. We have been seeing this kind of change where they actually just go 4-4-1. You would max out empower over the skewer because you realize that it gave you more damage, and it was to a certain extent I would almost argue that it's more reliable than a skewer because the right click is that thing which once you get the animation out, you know it's definitely going to be a hit. Compared to a skewer where it's skill drop. So alright guys, here we are. Esports versus EVOS. India versus Team Indonesia. Who's gonna win here guys? Okay, let's say EAPOC champ. If you guys think Entity's gonna win, EVOS is gonna win, give me a Ming Lee. So introducing now on the Radiant side for Entity Esports A35 playing the offlane. We're gonna have the Magnus versus Swifty. FK. Copter, no chance playing on the Ogre Magi, and Blizzard playing on the dire side. You have Stand-in Eden. Both, well, he's gonna be playing on that Elder Titan. Vil is gonna be playing on the Tidehunter. Francois playing on the K. Logic, Luna. Last but not least, you have Vlysu. Us, they get us. I don't know how you pronounce it on the Shadow Demon. He's already been spotted out. They know the ward is there, they will be warded. Get the ward. Nope, there we go. Easy 100. Tiny bit of EXP as well, it's gonna be split between the two heroes. Well guys, here we are. Looks like we're not gonna get the level 1 battle, but this will be a pretty good matchup. I mean, K going up against a Magnus. Be alright. Power is gonna be a huge thing. Well, Brief Fire is not going to be that big of a factor, like especially with the damage reduction. How much is it again? Level 1. 5% damage reduction, and that's why Empower is gonna be huge. To a certain extent, Swifty might not even be that reliant on Wave. You might just scale straight more power. So straight out that extra cleave as well as gonna be dwell in, Sven, and Disrupt. They actually have the potential to kill the Tide, but you need to kill him before he gets at least level 2 into the Kraken Shell. Give him maybe to the level 3 window. Top lane, we have ourselves a bit of a 2v3 situation. No chance. Surrounded by all these heroes. I don't think one will be standing there. No, I need to back up. So trying to run his way in, actually went on whirling death, very greedy, going into Vlysu. Well, he's very, very low. Looks like first blood here. Yeah, there we go. ETE getting the first blood. No chance, a bit low. Vlysu has nothing left. We'll be going back to base. There's no chance. Runs. Well, Eden Kiss just bashing him down. Alright. So Timbers are coming back to the lane, probably playing a bit too aggressive. Doubt that was the plan. The typical suicide which we are all too familiar with. Magnus also has, I would say, if he finds a good skewer, he might even get a good kill onto Francois, so just the DK to mess up this lane. Otherwise, this should static lane. We will look to the side lanes for that top lane where they're going ham to A35 again, bringing him low. Well, of course, with reactive armor, he will be okay. The stick already. This is something very similar to what Faceless does, where you make sure that you babysit, so make sure he gets to level 3. By the time you get that level 2 into the reactive armor, you're creep skipping, or at least you're able to, you know, drag creep aggro. It's a wonderful thing. Armor. So you have to rely solely on your magic damage. You can tell between the Elder Titan and the Shadow Demon as well that these guys, they're just kinda slowing down. The bottles well on the way. Has a lot of nuke available to him, though he doesn't have to worry so much about last hitting in this lane. Of course now the bottle, he can start sapping out shockwaves as well. Is he gonna bottle crow? Oh, okay, he is. Yeah, he's playing very, very aggressive. 2 points into the dragon's blood. Bottom lane, they haven't kill yet onto Tidehunter. He's quite a lot out of this lane. He's already almost level 3 after this creep wave. Disruptor, he's... Yeah, these, like I said, you know, these two, they can't really control him. And if anything, that terry window of which they could kill the Tide is gone. It's with 3 minutes and a half in, only one kill. Board. If we're lucky for game 2, CloudX is up and he will potentially be joining me. Anyways, Swifty just doing his bottle thing. I said this would be a very static lane. By the time you hit the level 6 though, it's really gonna boil down to these two. Who is going to actually be- Oh, he's gonna try and squip. Kenny, Dragon's Tail. Oh, you messed up. Dragon's Tail, longest stun at level 1 in this game. I'm not even surprised if chooses to not go for Ravage at all, just go for more points into Empower or something. Timbersaw kind of a bit starved of EX. He really needs those levels, especially once he gets to level 6, then maybe he can try for a bit more aggression. Shadow Demon or the Luna. Luna isn't exactly about that big, but not of a margin as well. Still lagging a bit behind. Of course, it's been gone for a while. Francois has to know what's going on here. Expect. Swifty might want to be a bit careful in moderation about using those spells now. Francois being a bit low. Bit tough, they're trying to go here into the Timbersaw top lane. iLogic taking a bit of harassment here, but he still has 8-1 charges. I don't think anyone's dying in this lane. Yeah, we're not gonna see anything yet. Ooh, Resident Sleeper game, guys. Resident. I have faith. Once you guys get the level 6 up, but in DK, we have an RP available. They might be thinking about it. Oh, I'm disappointed. Yeah, this is where they... It's one of those tricky... Where you can't leave him. Timbersaw and Ogre are just gonna bully her. And ooh, you can see that already! He actually just ripped apart the Luna. A bit too greedy. I actually missed that. I just looked away for like... I literally looked away for 1 second and he just went ham. Nicely done from this Timbersaw. Kill. Tide getting the bounty as well, he's gonna love this. As ancient stacks, I'm sure they're paying out as well, disruptors, so they are, I think they're happy with that. So this could potentially lead into one of those scenarios where he basically killed him after taking a tier 1. You can't even feel the ancient stacks. So this is a very delicate situation. How are you going to get the farm? But anyways, he's going to get glimpsed back. God Strength for this. They really want to kill this Tidehunter, but God Strength apparently not enough. They're even going to throw the Storm Hammer. Oh, that Anchor Smash. Damage. He's still hanging around, trapped by the Creep Wave. Could be a turnaround kill, but he has to play this very, very close. And actually, here comes back. No chance. Salve up. Not yet level 6. If that was really, really close. No chance. He's going in with the Ignite. Still should be okay here. He has to Kraken Shell. So yeah, he isn't down here. Plus, he has to Fairy Fire, but it was a close call. Gets out in 35 HP. Top lane. Yeah, looking for the Stomp. Maybe a Disruption. There we go. For the Stomp. Okay, it lands. But do they have enough damage? Team, alright. Cancel in the mid. Timber Chain. 835 could be a lot of trouble here. Pop. Will he be fine? No, he's gonna win. Okay, yeah, he's gonna... Bait. Yep, the final Lucent Beam, and iLogic will find himself another kill. Alright, so 2-1. Pine has level 6. They have the TPs available if they need to, I think. Well, at least only for the other Titan, not so much for Vlazu. But this should be the tier 1 taken, and this is going to leave the ancient stack here. Even though it's only a double stack, it's going to be vulnerable. He even gets the tower as well. No surprise, Sven of course top of the worth. Magnus is gonna try and build towards that blink dagger of his. He's halfway there. What are you doing? This is really a hard lane. Like, he's not the kind of hero which is mobile and quick enough that he can just rotate into a lane and try to gank. In a veil now, he's gonna pick up his Arcanian boots. That's a big start for him, so at least he can start to jungle as well. Pinging up the Elder Titan. Do they want to try for a kill here? They don't have God Strength, do they? They do? Okay. But I don't think he wants to go. He just wants to pick up his Helm of Dom. Stacking a bit. And this is good. This man go to the jungle. Of course, giving the Ogre a bit of space. This should even give him his level 5. Timbersaw Luna, like I said, this lane is very, very fragile. Yes, you have the Eclipse. But as Timbersaw gets more and more points up, pretty gonna die that easily. Since he has the Raindrop. A really good item, especially on a board where you want to be a bit more tanky and you always are starved of mana. The mana regen is a big thing. But I think here they could go for the Ogre. We might need potential dive under the tower. Shadow Demon could be heading to the mid as well. I mean, both supports from EVOS still off the map. This very, very worrisome. I mean, just look at all chance. Farming quite cocky. I'm pretty sure if you go for a disruption right now into him. Basically, he's gonna walk all the way in. There we go, the disruption. Stomp. And bang! Lands into the Ogre. Do we have anything else? Looking for the... Under the tower. No chance. No chance to survive. Chance to survive. No, he's gonna go straight for Vlesu. Do they have anything else? That 4 stacks. One more hit for Avil. He's gonna pop the stick charges. He's actually okay. He's not gonna die here. Okay, now he will go down to it. But okay, K keeping all the way in the trees, trapping him there. Give it a TP out. The glimpse Ogre Magi gets the kill. That damage. Enough, just at the very end. So, for one, your support for an offlaner, I think he would. Definitely not dying anytime soon. The Dragon Swarm early on. Looks like he's trying to stomp here, but it's to win. Has an Invis rune, so no luck. Not today, not today. Luna as well picking up his Helm of the Dominator. Battle of the Ancient Stacks begin. Like, you can see what it gives them, great vision on these stacks. Really, really big thing. You probably give it to the Tidehunter so that he gets the quick mech. Once you get the mech, you can start to group up a bit confidently. And at one point, he may even consider going for a pipe. Logic. It's getting very hard to solo lane against his Timbersaw now. 3 points into the reactive armor, and of course, the double points into the chain, so he can go to Tarzan onto Evo. Maybe a casual Hood of Defiance coming up onto have to worry so much about the nuke coming up from EVOS. Even just the cloak would be great. Haven't seen a Ravage yet, 11 minutes. 5 kills. But a stomp, maybe? Nah, it's gonna scout around. But anyways, they just want to show these ancient stacks, making sure that, you know, you spin. Ample amount of space so that he can farm. Especially since you guys know how scary a spin can be. Like, if you leave the stacks uncontrolled, when the spin meta first comes out, people will be like, alright, let's leave it. He's gonna be fat, so what? You know, outcomes like a Blink and Sanji, Yasha, bang, bang, bang. Whole team dead. And not to mention with Magnus to boot, level 3 and power, this could be a big thing. And he's almost on the Blink, 300 gold away. They're probably just trying to bait maybe this Titan to going for the stacks. I'm sure they know. Or they want to steal the stacks, they might even find the Titan. Swifty. We're going to see an RP committal here. I don't think you want to try doing this with a skill. You might want to be a bit more patient. They are backing up, but at the same time, everyone's just around the stacks. They want to make sure that the Tidehunter gets this. He just backs off, says, guys, I have a Blink Dagger. Just give me bottom creep, wait. Maybe just see. But Tide already has the recipe, chainmail, and he's gonna have good timing as well. Spend gonna pop the God Strength, immediately start chipping away. That was more magical, as EVOS will look for the tower trade as well. Dude, the Blink, we were still looking to this guy to make some big plays. Luna actually on top of net worth, may go into the Dragonlands or could just be going straight for the BKB. Anyways, let the stack stealing begin. Entity, they know what's going on. The teams are going back. They want to fight here. Fronts are really, really low. Even if they're double damage, he's not able to tank through this. They need to. Someone else inside. Magnus, are they going here? He has Blink. Have the empower onto him as well. They want to take attacks right now. Man, both sides are playing really, really passive. Avil walking a bit confident, a bit cocky. He just walked out of the ward. Swifty, can they actually... No, that's the crowd. I think they can. He's wanting them. He wants to fight. Of course, there's no getting a Tidehunter. These guys really want to make sure that they start something. This got into this very, very delicate point in the game where both sides have core items up because they've been farming relatively safely. DK will actually be going up Shadow Blade over the Blink Dagger. Man, this game is gonna be, you know, it's gonna be very, very safe. It's actually, ooh, the Sven, they ripped the Elder Titan apart to shreds. What's that? Bloodlust, Echo, he doesn't even have the Blink Dagger yet, but ET getting caught out. So, bottom lane, the tier 1 will be going the way of EVOS. It seems middle lane, looks like they're looking for fight hits. They find the Titan, now popping the Ravage, finding two heroes. But, 0835, all the way in the back line, right in front of the tier 1, is gonna try. Well, we cut down that Timothy. Well, in the Chakram, there we go. And of course, stuck in the kinetic bomb, they want to try and fight here. Of course, looking for the back, the Lucian Beam will catch 835 just barely, and he will just Tarzan away. Of course, they actually used the RP there to pull off. So the first RP used to hide pretty big, but still, even bigger part was that forced out the Ravage. No Ravage, Evo is not able to file. And the big thing is, you have God Strength coming up 25 seconds. I said, you know, Entity, they have shorter cooldowns on the spells. This is a really good defiance. So can actually stand in the front lines. He can just YOLO all the way in, and they can't do anything for him. They don't really have that good stun. The only reliable disable you have is from the Dragon's Tail. Francois. Yeah, they're just making sure. Trying to control the Ancients area, making sure it doesn't really do that much. But at the same time, Entity are definitely trading very, very nicely. Shadowbait still not yet used. He has yet to debut it. He wants to. He might even find a quick kill into the Disruptor. But oh no, the Glimpse back. They find the ETE. Out of the God Strike, the Stormhammer. They just bring down the ETE one more time. We'll try for the tier 1 mid. Meanwhile, top lane, that's also taken by iLogic, as they do have the level points into the grave. Very, very easy tower here for iLogic. Radiant structures are fortified. So Kuros' damage really, really amazing from the Dragon Form. Yeah, thinking about fighting, they do find Eden. He has been caught again. Now they pop the Ravage, catching three heroes, and this will be one down. Will they find another? He has really been brought down quickly. And actually, no, he misses the RP completely. And that's gonna be the spent on the DK, cutting him down. Can they find Evil as well? Now comes the Aegis, comes out Luna. Between all these heroes, looks like she will go down as well. Then they cut her off, and they want the revenge, they will get it. Full team wipe and the Aegis kill. 6 for 1 trade, only losing the Ogre Magi in the process. Big fight coming out here. Alright, sorry about that early on, looks like my mic was kind of facing. Anyways, a very, very quick tier 2 going the way of Entity Esports. Warcry is an amazing spell, not to mention you saw the power of the Empower right there. TP coming in from the DK, I don't think that's the plan. You don't go there, he pops the Shadow Blade. Do they have detection? They do not. You must try to go for Blizzard. Pops the Dragon Form, the Gush. Immediately, stop Blizzard, stunned for 1,000 years. In between all these heroes, with the Anchor Smash, they find one more kill. Blizzard gonna try to find his way through. Darn tanky. Harry, 433 gold going the way of the Shadow Demon. Good pick off. Middle tower is under attack.
Regeneration.
Gold for me.
Anyways, middle lane looks like they want to try and fight here. Francois, 2k gold, might look into going into the BKB. Open AC, but hello, hello, they see a huge tasty stack. Thank you, Sven, and like I said, you know, called it from the draft. Placing a lot of emphasis on the stacks. Just want to keep stealing the Ancient Axe, and then they're just going to use the Dragon Form Farm 1 and go to the next.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Big, big stuff. And Entity Esports, well, this game's still relatively even. Besides, don't make the lead. I mean, we're 20 minutes in. I mean, still barely a 500 gold lead in favor of Entity Esports. And actually, it should be going the way of EVOS. But you look at it, Entity Esports have power kill advantage, but EVOS, they have the Roche advantage. So no surprise there. Logic would probably hit to make down. Couldn't even go to time to Yasha. But hello, the smoke gang coming from Entity Esports. Will they find it? Entity. Got it. Just gonna go back to take the stacks. Yeah, Ravage. Oh. They know what's going on. Disruptor goes up. just taking care of the wards. Eden playing a very risky position. No, he's there. Blizzard doesn't even have a blink. He actually wanted to go for the BKB over the blink. Alright, so 10-8. And they do this. They need just one big RP fight. Very easy to execute. Find the RP. They need to control the map a bit better.
Double damage. Radiant's top tower is under
going
attack.
For the Silver's Edge. This is a good item against the Timber Song. And I guess the damage. Oh, how much is it again? It's. Okay. 50%. Yeah, that's really good against the Sven as well.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
It looks like we may see a fight as right now they're trying to do pressure here on the tier 2 bottom lane. Luna using a double damage, gonna try and take the trade as well. Not a good trade here for Entity as EVOS are forcing them back. And if gone out, Avil now a bit more confident than Ford. Blizzard, do they know he's alone? Magnus always at the trees, they had a good one. But the damage to find it, only the other time back, will it? Oh, trying to skewer away. Dropped it out, not exactly a good one, very, very awkward. And now they get the stun into the Tidehunter, and now they have enough damage to BKB. Gonna expire just very, very soon. A 10-second BKB. Oh, time is running out. Time is running out. Looking for the screw back. Pushes all the way back. The Ravage only catches heroes. And now they can find one. They find two. Double kill for the loop. Moving on for the third. Will they find anyone else? Apparently not. As the T out from the disrupt. It's a very good ward. Just trying to make sure that the Tide wasn't stuck hiding here or something. And alright. EVOS Gaming finding themselves a very good fight. Killing off two cores. Big cores. And that's going to be EVOS pushing up the bottom lane, potentially taking the tier 2 bottom lane. Okay, 3 minutes in EVOS, I think for the first time, we have a goal lead over 2,000 for the first time this game 1. Francois is now going to start chilling at this bottom tier 2. Very easy. Disruptor didn't get a good ult, but trapping Dragon Knight near the tier 2, it doesn't matter. Another demon of the illusions, the four lunas. Timbersaw struck moment. Oh, doesn't really get dump off. There. Find him. No mana as well into front. Oh. Sven really needs blink. I presume it's on the way. Yes, it is. Gotta give credit to this Luna as well, not going to BKB, that was a really big ravage into the Eclipse. Now looking for the glimpse back, they do find Vlaisu. Saying hi. A Yield Scepter would be a really big item. Well, but hold on, looks like they're trying to go into 835, they pop the Silver's Edge and they get the Dragon in the world, the chain. And oh no, Timber. Tower's in the way. Gold into your DK. Dragon's actually getting quite fat. Very soon his won't be able to carry him. Like, because of this AoE splash damage, he actually farms a lot quicker compared to, you know, this Magnus, who has been pretty much just emphasizing this is a very all-in strat where you want to make sure that Blizzard use the majority of the DPS. Without Blizzard, you actually don't take fight at all. Doesn't really do much. It's just a, you know, a 4-staff and a blink. Found him. Still spread. He's going to be able to get out.
Radiant's top tower has fallen.
Sven is still on top, they could still try for a pick. Need a smoke for Holland, it looks like they will find themselves a willingly served target. That's a chance. Pop the mech. Be dying here anyways. Yep. They kill Shadow Demon, getting purged as well. It looks like Timberstar, he's gonna try and kill the ET. The Ravage if they still wanna use it. Going out a gush onto the Timberstar. And they wanna fight here. Can they get the kill? Laying out the Chakram, just scaring off that fish. But over there at the top half, laying out the Earthstone, and now looks like he will find a lot of damage. And now the Ravage catching three heroes. Now here comes the Eclipse as well. There'll be a Blizzard down, and Swifty all the way inside the trees will get out. Timbersaw gonna try and do whatever damage he can. He really wants to kill Eden, but he has to chain away. He has to run. Francois gonna be chasing him with the Silver's Edge. Will they look for the Dragon's Tail? Yes, they will. Click onto him, maybe. Oh, there we go. And that's a lot of damage. Timbersaw, no reactive armor. Just very, very easy target. Quick pick. So, goodbye, Blaster Charges. And that's gonna be three kills going the way of EVOS as they find themselves more momentum into the game. Avil, of course, taunting them with a nice bit of a backstroke.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
The 27 minutes in, EVOS, they find themselves a really, really good advantage of the game time. Sven didn't even chance to pop the BKB, so I'm not sure what was really going on there. That Ravage, really on point. Avil has been able to do quite a lot. Needs to invest into a BKB as well so that he can just go in without having to worry about his blink. Like, oh, I think twice now. Once over here, once over here. Haven't seen any really impressive RPs yet. Find a stop, onto the the entity, they obviously have to draft, but they. Right now, what they're lacking severely is just execution. Ironically, like, their name says Entity Sports, but they're not playing like a real entity at all. They're just playing like, organisms. Really not sure what they want to do. Constantly being put into a very awkward position. EVOS have done very well in their fights. Like, he's been setting them up every single fight. Like, you know, Luna's ult is not exactly that reliable. Now going in for the Anchor Smash, they pop the BKB and the God Strength still on. They want to try and go for a counter fight here. But now starting with the BKB and the Purge onto the Sven. Oh, this could be big. And it's never arrived. The RP only hatched into the Luna. No, it comes in for 10 seconds. And Avil, he's going all the way in. He's very, very low. 15 seconds. He's falling for the Ravage with DLI. Can he kill him off? Now the kill comes up. Nice disruption. The demon keeping him alive. And oh, they find the kill. But Tide's still alive. And now they're popping the Eclipse. WT Timbersaw going down, taking a ton of damage with the gust to his backside. And three go down as EVOS lose absolutely nothing. Chasing Avil around for what seems like an eternity. And they were going to find no chance. No chance, no life, that's for sure, because they won't find him looking for the stop. Not really, but the pre-fire broke tag onto him just barely. No chance. Do they know he's actually, oh my god, is he actually gonna TP out? No way. Get out. What is this? That one tree, the tree of life. And that's gonna be EVOS going right now for the Roshan. Roshan and the game going their way. Once again, just steal those RPs. Not really coming out. He's only getting single target RPs. Yeah, we haven't seen those huge RPs where he catches multiple heroes in that ultimate before the synergy to follow up with the spend and the disruption. Time he's going for these very forced RP. When EVOS did just go in straight for multiple Ravages, and because they still have the Ravage and this down middle lane or even the bottom lane, and then you can go straight for the lane of barracks to try and siege high ground. Alright, so anyways, Avil, he's gonna look push out the lanes a bit, get the lanes in their favor. A35. Want some alone time in the trees, maybe a HY fanboy. Luna and SD just doing rat thing. Very, very annoying thing. You have to give credit to EVOS. They relied purely on their primary skills fight. Fighting around. I mean, great play coming up from the SD, keeping the Tide alive. And because, you know, Guardian Greaves, you guys don't really know. The aura boost threshold, especially when you're really, really low below 10 HP, you get an extra boost. Quick kill, they have this tree there. Find a quick kill though. Yes. Oh no, they will not. Close one. big card. Fortunately, his HP does not. An anchor smash. Ooh, there we go. Kill it, kill a card. There we go. K35 just resorting to creep skipping right now. He waves. Sure that they don't have any kind of push, but unfortunately the mid wave is coming in. But so far tanking it up. He still has the Aegis, the Sword Crest, and the Silver's Edge. This guy is really, really tanky at 21 HP. Of course, now with the Shadow Demon Illusions, the Lunar Illusions will probably take care of it. Of course, we all know the power of a Lunar, how quickly they siege towers. Can they take it down? Start chipping away, and oh, looking for the RP. This is the first double RP. He's got it all shaped into the disrupt. Ultimate with the BKBs will finally be popped into the Eclipse and Blizzard. He's gonna pop this on BKB. Can't even do damage, but unfortunately, not locking this right clicks him down, and the buyback will come out. Three heroes immediately taken out quickly, ASAP in a second. And Entity East lose this game one as we wait. Enter into game two. Whew.